Welcome back to another video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. For this video, I'm going to be making an extended press-on set. So I'm starting off with this first nail, which is the ring finger, and I'm just going to be encapsulating some of this blue glitter from the Macart Ocean Couture nail decoration kit. So I just put base coat gel on the nail, and I'm just taking a small brush and just placing the glitter on the nail. I'm trying to make sure that I'm putting it as flat as possible and making sure that the glitter flakes aren't really overlapping too much. So that way when I go back in to encapsulate it only using base coat gel, I can make sure that it's not too bumpy and it's nice and smooth. If you're new to my channel or you haven't seen some of my more recent videos, I will leave a link in the cards to the playlist where I show how I create my extended press-on nails by putting two nail tips together, the half-cover extended coffin nail tips from AliExpress, and then some full-cover coffin nail tips that I cut down. And I just put them together using base coat gel and filed them down. But if you're interested in seeing that process, then I will leave that link in the cards. For the thumb, I'm going to be encapsulating some foil, and these foils are from a Vetsy Poly Gel Kit, so I'll leave that link in the description box along with everything else that I'm using. But I'm just encapsulating it using base coat gel, so I'm just putting it into the uncured base coat. I'm going to cure that into place, and then I'm just going to go over all of the nails with some base coat gel. But I also wanted to mention that last night on Instagram, I saw that Enail Couture just came out with their 5XL coffin nail tips, which these 5XL nail tips are longer than the other two 5XL shapes that they've made in the past. So I'm going to insert a picture of it, but I wanted to say that I feel like this method that I'm using in this video is a good dupe for that. If anyone was looking at that and was thinking about purchasing it, if you're into doing like the Femi Beauty method, then I would say that that would probably be a good option to go ahead and buy it. But if not, if you're just trying to make press-ons, I would highly recommend using the method that I used in this video. And even if you wanted a longer shape, because I think the ones that Enail Couture made are slightly longer than these that I have in the video, but on AliExpress, the vendor that sells these nail tips does have an even longer version of them. It's like listed as 3XL, I think. So if you click that link in my description box to the nail tips, then you'll see that longer option. So yeah, you can use the same technique and get that same look. So yeah, I just wanted to mention that. But now I'm going on to the middle finger, which is my marble nail. So I put some base coat gel on the nail. I didn't cure that in the lamp. I'm going right in with these two colors from the 36 color gel pot kit on AliExpress. And I'm just going to marble those colors together, and then at the top towards the cuticle area, I'm going to smooth it out a little bit because I want it to do somewhat of like an ombre look. So yeah, I'm just going to kind of fade that towards the cuticle area, and then I'm just going to cure that in the lamp. Also, I wanted to go ahead and do my featured comment. So thank you so much, Jenny G, for being first to comment on my previous upload. I really appreciate it. If y'all aren't already subscribed to her channel, I would highly, highly recommend that you go and subscribe. I feel like if you're watching my videos and you're already subscribed to my channel, then you probably have already come across hers. But she has some amazing videos, beautiful designs, and some awesome hauls. I love watching her haul videos. She gets so many goodies. And she also sells press-on nails, and she has like nail decoration mystery bundles and stuff that she sells on her Etsy shop. So definitely go check that out. I'm going to leave her channel linked in the description box and her Etsy shop and all that good stuff. So yeah, definitely go check it out. Right now in the video, I'm just going in with my base coat gel. So I do about 2 to 3 layers whenever I do this technique just to build the nails up a bit. Now I'm going in with this Born Pretty gel polish in the shade SP04, and this is going to be my natural nail bed color. So I'm just putting that on the marble nail, and I just wanted to make it look a little bit like an ombre, but I didn't really go in with the fan brush or anything in the way that I would typically do an ombre. I just went in and tried to kind of brush it down a little bit, and then I just cured that in the lamp. For the pointer finger, I'm doing a French tip nail, and I decided to just go ahead and paint it on myself. So I'm just going in with this gel pot, and I'm just going to go in and try my best to get a nice smile line. This wasn't perfect, but I already knew I was going to be putting some bling over it, so I wasn't really too worried about it. But I'm going to do 2 coats for this French tip, and I'm going to cure it in between each coat. At this point, I decided to go ahead and put the nails on before I finish off the design with all of my accents, like bling and extra foil. So I'm just going in and applying some peel off base coat because I don't plan on wearing these nails for long. But if you did want to do your press ons to last for about 2 to 3 weeks, then you would want to go in and just lightly file the shine off of your natural nail and then go in with some dehydrator and primer. I'm also using some of the McCart nail glue, which I highly recommend. It's the best in my opinion. But yeah, I went back in with some more of that Born Pretty gel polish just to build that color up, and then I decided I wanted to add some gold glitter to my marble, so I just went in with some base coat gel and I'm just taking this glitter. I think I got this from AliExpress and a small brush, and I'm just kind of putting it in random spots on the marble, and I'm just going to cure that into place. So now I've taken the nails off of the nail stand and I'm just going in with some of the McCart nail glue to glue them on. So now I'm going back to the encapsulated ring finger and I'm putting some base coat gel all over the nail, and then I'm just going to take a small brush and outline the nail with some gold foil. I'm curing that nail in the lamp, and now I'm going to be going in to add my bling. So those are all of the rhinestones that I'm using. If you've been watching my previous videos, then you saw how I mentioned that I kind of wanted to go through all of the different colors of bling that I just recently got from AliExpress. So now I'm on the blue ones. Again, I'm adding one of these bigger stones with the gold around it. I wish I would have gotten one that had a blue, like the blue rhinestones that you see, but I didn't have any, so I decided to incorporate some silver into the set to kind of match that white stone in the center. So I'm just going in and applying some of that, and I'm using the Enel Couture gummy jelly to apply it. So I just put that on the nail, then I go over it with some top coat gel, and then I'm just using my wax pen to place all of the stones. So I cured that bigger one into place, and now I'm on the pointer finger and I'm just doing some along the smile line. So I'm just going back and forth between some of the gold rhinestones and then some of the silver or white stones. For the pinky, I did a glass nail and I'm just adding some bling to it. So I'm doing the Enoch Couture gummy jelly down the center of the nail, and then I'm going to go over it with some top coat gel, and then I'm just going to place my stones. I really do love the way that this set turned out with the gold and silver stones. I just think it's so pretty. So yeah, I'm kind of glad actually that I didn't have the blue piece to put in the center, because that stone is what made me kind of decide to go in with both the silver and the gold, and I think it turned out really nice, especially with the foils and stuff too. So yeah, for this one I'm just putting some of the bigger ones in the center. I did a gold piece in the middle, and then I'm just putting two of the blue pieces on either side of it, and then I'm just going to take some of the smaller white ones because I don't have any of the other shapes for these silver or white stones. So I'm just putting the little circles all around it, and I'm just going to do the same thing on the top and bottom and each side, and then I'm just going to cure that in the lamp. I'm also going to add some bling along the cuticle of the thumb, and that's all of the bling that I'm going to be adding, I believe. Yeah, that's all of the bling I'm going to be adding. Once I finished applying all of the rhinestones, I stopped recording, but I actually went back in and top coated the underside of the thumb and the ring finger, oh, and the pinky also, since that is a glass nail. But yeah, that was pretty much it for this nail design. I think these are so beautiful. Let me know what y'all think of them in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, be sure to subscribe. Press that notification bell so that you're notified when I upload. And yeah, I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.